Conflict detection is a feature of the Change Management application and is contained in the Change Management Collision Detector plugin. Conflict detection helps to identify potential scheduling clashes based on different conflict types. An example of a conflict type would be a configuration item that's scheduled at the same time of an existing change. Another example would be a parent or child of that configuration item that is scheduled for the change, or when a requested change occurs during a blackout period or outside a scheduled maintenance window. One thing to note is that even though certain types of change requests may trigger a conflict detection, these conflicts can be overridden in situations that warrant it. For instance, a down server may require a reboot even though there is an existing change blackout. Conflict detection is property driven. This allows you to determine which parameters to use to define a conflict. This can all be done in the Conflict Properties module. By default, when a change request has the configuration item, plan start date, and plan end date populated and saved, conflict detection will execute. When conflicts are identified, a message will appear in the change request form notifying you of the identified conflicts. These conflicts can then be evaluated and the change request updated as appropriate. These properties allow you to choose what kind of conflicts you want to occur. You can select or deselect your options with these checkboxes. Here we have the option for the configuration item conflict check mode. Our choices are basic mode, which will only check the CIs listed in the change, or advanced mode, which checks the entire affected configuration items related list. We would click here to save any changes, but we'll leave these the way they are. To get a better understanding of conflict detection and to highlight some of its features, let's look at the following scenario. Let's say we need to schedule the maintenance of one of our servers. We'll need to create a change. So let's go ahead and do that. We fill out the necessary information first. Once it's created, let's schedule it to start at 4 p.m. and end at 5 p.m. And then let's save. Returning to our change form, we see that the conflict field indicates that conflicts have been detected. So let's look under the Conflicts tab to see what's going on. Here we're provided a list view of all the conflicts that exist with our change request. Under the Type column, we're provided the reason for the conflict. This conflict was detected because the same CI on our change is already scheduled on an existing change during the time that we tried to schedule ours. This conflict is because we didn't schedule our change within the maintenance window, and this conflict is because we scheduled our change during a blackout window, a time when no changes are to be scheduled. Clicking here takes us directly to the change conflict calendar, showing us the change schedule. Here we can see our change, along with the conflicts associated with our change request. In this case, the conflicts are the blackout schedule, the designated maintenance window, and the change that contains the same CI. By clicking on our change in the calendar view, we have the option to view and edit the planned start date and planned end date for our change. Or we can simply drag our change to the proper time schedule to avoid the detected conflicts. Let's move it here so it occurs within the maintenance window and then click Save. This will also eliminate our other conflicts. When we return to the change, we can see that the planned start and end times have been updated accordingly, and we no longer have any conflicts. Now that you know how conflict detection works, put it to use to help you optimize the scheduling of changes around your maintenance windows, blackout windows, and other related scheduled change activity. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.